assets and expenses, credit side, incomes and liabilities. When they give the trial balance, 400 may come, may not come. The real value you are going to receive is only 76,000. So stock discharge to the value of how much? 13,000. How much insurance company is going to pay? 10,000. Interest on what we have taken the loan, how much interest you have to pay? 3,600. This is profit and loss account, debit side. You must be very careful about this. Any purchase which is omitted is called credit purchases. It should be added to purchases. Hello, my dear student. I am Dr. B.S. Subramania, called by name Dr. B.S.S., professor in commerce and management, Vidyashram First Aid College, a temple of excellence, Mysuru. I am going to handle financial accounting 1 of first semester BBA. The chapter goes final accounts of sole trading concern. So what do you mean by sole trading concern? An individual business. It is a one-man business. Entire is controlled by one man. When you say final account, this is the last account prepared by a single man business. He has to take the interest because the profit or loss depends on how the individual is considered. Why it is called final accounts means this is prepared at the end of the year. After preparing this, no more accounts to be prepared. So final accounts has got 3 division. One is trading account, one is profit and loss account, one is the balance sheet. Which are the 3 divisions? Are trading account, profit and loss account and a balance sheet. Trading account gives the results of gross profit or gross loss. Only direct expenditure, purchase and sale will be taken into consideration. For example, he purchased the goods worth of rupees 1 lakh. He made an expenditure for wages is 40,000. When you say what is the total cost of the purchase, we say 1,40,000. Made the sale for rupees 2 lakh, difference 60,000 is called the gross profit. So directly, all expenditure directly connected. Which are the direct expenditures are wages, carriage inward, freight, manufacturing expenses, power. So it has been sold to a higher value. The difference is gross profit or gross loss. Then it will enter to profit and loss account where indirect expenses and indirect income will be taken into consideration. Then we'll move on to the balance sheet. Balance sheet is not an account. It is a statement of assets and liability which shows the financial position of the concern. So what's a balance sheet? It is not an account. It is a statement of assets and liability. It shows the financial position of the concern. How much asset we are having, how much liability you have to pay. So all the final account based on the trial balance. They will give the trial balance. So what is trial balance? Trial balance shows the arithmetical accuracy of books of account. What is trial balance? It shows arithmetical accuracy of books of account. It has got 2 sides. One is called the debit side and is called the credit side. All these balances is taken from the ledger. Ledger is prepared with the help of the journal entry. How it goes? First journal entry to ledger, ledger to trial balance. True, trial balance has 2 sides. One is called debit side and is called the credit side. What the debit side shows? Assets and expenses, credit side, incomes and liability. I will repeat. The trial balance has 2 sides. One is debit side, another is called the credit side. What the debit side says? All assets and in expenses on the debit side, incomes and liability credit side. So they will give the trial balance, they will give the adjustment. So you have to prepare a trading account, profit and loss account and a balance sheet. The item from the trial balance should appear only one. Should appear only once, either in the trading account or in the profit and loss account or in the balance sheet. Whereas the adjustment item should appear minimum 2 times, sometimes 3 times. Minimum 2 times. It may be 3 times. I'm going to explain the problem now. We'll move on to the problem now. The following is the trial balance relates to Anjali Traders as on 31st December 2003. So closing date is 31st December 2003. Mean start with January, end with December, which is called calendar year. If we start with April, end with March, which is called the financial year. How it is? Start with January, end with December is called calendar year. Start with April, end with March is called financial. Here it closed on 31st December 2003, mean 1-1-2003 to 31st December 2003, a duration of 12 months, a duration of 12 months. They are given a trial balance here. Try debit side and the credit side. What I told you, debit side shows assets and expenses, credit side, incomes and liability. When they give the trial balance, you must be in a position to bifurcate where the items can come, where it will go, either a trading account, profit and loss account, balance sheet, asset side or liability. I will bifurcate now. Machinery is an asset. Furniture is an asset. Machinery is an asset. Furniture is an asset. Then, stock on one is opening stock, trading account. Drawings and capital. Capital is 1,75,000. This will come on the liability side. Drawing minus capital. This should be deducted from capital. It should be deducted from capital. Purchases and sale. Purchase is how much? 4,80,000. This will come trading account, debit side. This is called trading account, credit side. It will come on credit side. It will come on debit side. Here debit, credit. Debit is called sales return. Credit is called purchase return. I will repeat. Sales return. Purchase return. How it goes? Purchase return. Purchase return. Sales return. Sales return. Purchase return. Then debtor and credit. Debtor is an asset. Creditor is a liability, which we have to pay. How much money is payable? 51,000. Debtor is an asset. Creditor is a liability. Then, wages trading account. It comes under trading account, directly connected. We'll move on. Salary for 11 months means 1 month rent is outstanding. How much you paid? 22,000 you paid. For how many months? 11 months. 11 twos are 22,000 still payable. You paid 7,800 for how many months? 13 months. So, 600. So, 600, 1 month is prepaid, 1 month is outstanding. 1 month is prepaid, 1 month is outstanding. So, salary comes under profit and loss account. Then, rent comes under profit and loss account. Insurance comes under profit and loss account, debit side. Advertisement, profit and loss account. You must be in a position, such a bifurcation, you must also carry inward, trading account. Raw material is coming in. Carry outward, profit and loss account. Bank overdraft is a liability. This is a liability item. Investment is an asset. Interest on investment, profit and loss account, credit side. Interest on, we have taken the loan, how much interest you have to pay? 3,600. This is profit and loss account, debit side. This is discount allowed. This is discount received. Discount allowed, profit and loss, debit side. This is profit and loss, credit side. One is the received item, one is the allowed item. It's an expenditure, this is an income. Commission on sale. We paid commission on sale. It is profit and loss, debit side. It's an expenditure item. Profit and loss account, debit side. So salary, profit and loss account, debit side. Rent, profit and loss account, debit side. Insurance, profit and loss account, debit side. Advertisement, profit and loss account, debit side. Carryage inward, trading account. Carryage outward, profit and loss account. Bank overdraft is a liability. Investment is an asset. Interest on investment is an income. Interest on overdraft. We have taken the loan. For that, we have to pay. How much paid you have got? 3,600 is already paid. Discount allowed is expenditure. Discount received is this is an income. This is an expenditure. Commission on sale. We paid commission on sale. How much money? 12,000 is an expenditure. General expense is profit and loss account, debit side. Bad debt means irrecoverable money, profit and loss account, debit side. What is bad debt? Irrecoverable income from the customer is called the bad debt. Cash in hand is asset. You must be you have to see that how I bifurcate. Same thing, you must be in a position to bifurcate which are the assets are, which are the liabilities are, which are the expenses are, which are the incomes are. These items should appear only once, either in trading account or in profit and loss account or in a balance sheet. We'll move on to adjustment. What is the first adjustment? Closing stock. 1,35,000. Where it will come? trading account credit side, asset side of the balance sheet. Where it will come? Trading account credit side, asset side of the balance sheet. Then stock destroyed is 13,000 on 24, and insurance agreed to pay the insurance claim rupees 10,000 only. So stock destroyed to the value of how much? 13,000. How much insurance company going to pay? 10,000. Totally 13,000. How much insurance company going to pay? 10,000. How much you could not recover? 3,000. 13,000 will come trading account credit side. 10,000 asset side of the balance sheet. 3,000 profit and loss account debit side as loss on stock destroyed. How to show? 13,000 trading account credit side. 10,000 asset side of the balance sheet. 3,000 profit and loss account debit side as loss on stock destroyed. Once again, I will tell you, 13,000 trading account credit side. 10,000 asset side of the balance sheet as due from insurance company. Then 3,000 is a loss, profit and loss account debit side, loss on stock destroyed. Then create provision for doubtful debt, 5% on debtor. On the debtor, we assume that how much money we could not receive, 5,000. May not come. This is called RBD, new RBD, reserve for bad and doubtful debt. Debt may come, may not come. Then purchase the value of 5,000, 20 had been omitted to be recorded. Any cash purchase is correctly entered. Any credit purchases has been omitted. It should be added to purchases. Then we have to pay this amount to a creditor, seller. We purchase how much? 5,000, which have been omitted to be recorded because it is a credit purchase. Add to purchases. Then on the liability side of the balance sheet, you have to show creditor for purchases. How to show that? Add 5,000 to, especially for purchases in trading account, it is nothing but a credit purchases. We have to pay how much money? 5,000. That will come on the liability side of the balance sheet as creditor for purchases. Then depreciate the machinery 15% for nature 10. The value of the machinery has been come down to the extent of 15%. That value will be shown in the profit and loss account debit side. Furniture value has been come down 10%. So both will come on the debit side of profit and loss account. While you're doing in the balance sheet, deduct from machinery, deduct from furniture, the value has been come down to the extent of 15% to the extent of 10%. I will repeat once again. Closing stock, trading account credit side, asset side of the balance sheet. How it is? Trading account credit side, asset side of the balance sheet. 13,000 trading account credit side. Then 10,000 asset side of the balance sheet. Difference is 3,000 profit and loss account debit side as loss on stock destroyed. Create the provision for doubtful debts. What is the formula? B plus N minus O. What is B plus N minus O? Bad debt plus new RBD minus old RBD. Bad debt in the trial balance, new RBD in the adjustment, old RBD in the trial balance credit side. What is the formula? Bad debt plus new RBD minus old RBD. What is the formula? Bad debt plus new RBD minus old RBD. Old RBD trial balance credit side, new RBD adjustment, bad debt in the trial balance. Then purchase this 5,000 and 28 has been omitted to be recorded. Why it is omitted to be recorded? It's a credit purchase. If it is a cash purchase, would have been entered properly. It's a credit purchase, no? That's why it has been omitted to be recorded. Add to purchases, you have to pay how much money? 5,000 to your seller. He becomes our creditor. Company becomes the debtor and he becomes the creditor. Worth of how much? 5,000. That 5,000 should be added to purchases. Then you show that 5,000 on the liability side of the balance sheet as creditor for purchaser. We see that how the problem will be solved. We'll move on to this. Your opening stock as per the problem is 1,20,000. You made a purchase of 4,80,000. How much have goods have been returned on the credit side? 10,000 deducted. What's the balance? 4,70,000. How much credit purchase has been made, which has been omitted? 5,000. Real purchase become 4,75,000. Wages paid is 45,000. Carriage inward means raw material is coming into the extent of 12,000. Come back to credit side. Your sales is 7,40,000. Out of that, how much return? 20,000. Real sale become how much? 7,20,000. Closing stock means unsold stock.
unsold stock to the extent of 1,35,000. Stock destroyed, full value 13,000. What's the value of the stock destroyed? 13,000. If you add the figure, it is 8,68,000. It will come 8,68,000. The difference has been come 2,16,000, which is considered as a gross profit. This is your gross profit. Transfer to profit and loss account. We'll move on to profit and loss account. By gross profit brought down 2,16,000 taken from the trading account. By discount received 8,000. By interest on investment 6,000. So nothing but trial balance credit side. Come back to debit side. Salary 22,000 for 11 months. How much month outstanding here? This is 1 month outstanding comes to 2,000. Add 24,000. Your rent paid for 13 months. This is for 13 months. You paid for 13 months minus prepaid 1 month. How much? 7,800 divided by 13 comes to 600. So see, deduct the 600. Actual amount you have to pay is 7,200. Your insurance premium paid 2,400. For sake of advertisement, you paid 12,000. Carriage outward, finished goods is going out 10,000. Then interest on overdraft is an expenditure that will come P&L account debit side. You have discount allowed to customer is an expenditure 13,000. Commission paid 12,000. General expenses 7,500. Your bad debt is 1,700. If you see your trial balance, you understand your debtor figure. See that your machinery purchase return stock. Your debtor is how much? 80,000. On that, how much new provision is created? 5%. 5% of 80,400 may come, may not come. The real value you are going to receive is only 76,000. What is the formula? Bad debt plus new RBD minus old RBD. What is the formula? Bad debt plus new RBD minus old RBD. Same thing you have done. See this? Your bad debt is 1,700 plus new RBD. This is nothing but 80,000 into 5/100. This is 80,000 into 5/100 works out how much? 4,000. There's no RBD. 5,700. As per the problem, your stock destroyed is 13,000. How much you are going to receive from insurance companies? 10,000. How much is irrecoverable? 3,000. That's a loss on stock destroyed. We move on to next one. We have to calculate depreciation of machinery. The cost of the machinery is 80,000. 15% works out 12,000. The value of the furniture is 26,000. 10% of this workout, 2,600. Totally, it becomes 14,600. Your credit side total is 2,30,000. Difference will work out 1,15,000, which can be transferred to your capital, say, balance sheet. If you go with the balance sheet, your trial balance shows cash in hand is an asset. Debtor is asset. On that, new RBD is 4,000. The balance is 76,000. Unsold stock is 1,35,000. Due from insurance company is 10,000. Means out of 13,000, how much is receivable? 10,000. How much is irrecoverable is 3,000. That goes to profit and loss account. Your machinery value is 18,000. Less depreciation 15%. It works out 12,000. The balance is 68,000. Your furniture value is 26,000. Less depreciation at 10%. 10% of 26,000 is 2,600. It goes 23,400. Your investment value is 40,000. Your prepaid rent for 1 month is 600. So we have to pay to creditor 51,000. How much bank overdraft is 30,000? We have taken the loan. We have to pay the outstanding rent. 11 months, 22,000 divided by 11 is 2,000 we have to pay. We started with a balance of 1,75,000. We earn a profit of 1,15,000. It becomes 2,90,000. Out of that, he draw how much money? 20,000. How much balance available? 2,70,000. We purchases which have been omitted is, I told you, it's a credit purchase. Add to purchases, then liabilities are up the balance sheet. You must be very careful about this. Any purchase which is omitted is called credit purchases. It should be added to purchases. Then liability set up the balance sheet. I've explained the trading account. I've explained the profit and loss account. I've explained the trial balance. So So they will give the trial balance and adjustment. The items in the trial balance should appear only once, either in the trading account or in the profit and loss account or in the balance sheet. The items of the adjustment should appear twice, once in trading account, once in a balance sheet, once in a profit and loss account, once in a balance sheet, or both can be appear on the assets and liabilities of the balance sheet. So this session, I have discussed about the trial balance and the adjustment. I told what is trial balance, what is adjustment to do. The items from the trial balance should appear only once. The items in the adjustment will appear twice. So in the next session, we'll have one more problem regarding the final accounts is considered with the good adjustment. Till then, goodbye. Meet in the next class with another good problem.